another girl like you.
Yeah.
girl like you.
I will tell her.
Never want another girl like you.
Because I'm literally just looking under the couch. Because
why are you looking under the couch?
Supposedly there was something there. And then this bizarre, like, you know how they have stuffed teddy bears, right? Well, there was this like stuffed teddy bear, but it was like a snake serpent. And it was like coming, crawling. It was moving back and forth, right? In the living room. It was like, it was going across the floor.
On its own.
Yeah. And it was just some bizarre shit, right? But then I was suddenly awake, and I'd been dreaming.
This is real?
Yeah, I was like about 3 years old.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
You remember a dream when you were three?
Yeah.
That's kind of screwy, man.
Hey, just because I like taking it up a notch, keeping it out of the gutter. How old would you say you were when you had your first wet dream?
Oh, shit. Definitely anywhere from like 12 to 14. I don't remember exactly, but I'd say it's around there, probably. Maybe 14, 15-ish.
Yeah. Dude, I don't know what the fuck happened with me, but I remember having my first wet dream. I had to be fucking 4 or 5.
What the fuck?
Yeah, yeah, crazy.
That's
shit.
Crazy.
I know. I remember it, too, and it's like, I remember, you know, when I look back at it, it's like, well, why did that happen because of that? How are those two connected?
Mm-hmm.
What is the corollary?
of course you're going to be kind of confused. Like, you don't know what the fuck is going on with that.
Well, yeah, especially when you're like, you're here, you lay down, you close your eyes, and then you're there.
And you're in a good place.
Well, you're in a good place, but sometimes you're in that weird place.
Oh, of course.
Where it's like, Okay, hey, somebody, is it just me or is that fucking teddy bear snake thing really moving?
Yeah.
Because I've been in situations where...
But that wasn't the wet dream, right? Let's just get that out there.
That was the teddy bear crawling around. Okay. Not the wet dream. That's a good thing to clarify.
Yeah, because you just kind of moved into this teddy bear dream. Like, really, you have a thing for creepy, autonomous teddy bears, huh?
Well, you know, another thing, speaking of teddy bears,
yeah.
The whole Five Nights with Freddy or something like whatever the fuck it was.
Five Nights at Freddy's.
Five Nights at Freddy's, yeah. I've played the game. Now, you know, I've played a lot of games.
Yeah.
We both know this. I never got Freddy. I never understood how to play the fucking game. I'd always fucking die. I'd be like, I'm looking at the cameras. Okay, yeah, shit's moving, but I fucking close the door, fucking power goes out. You know, and the next thing you know,
jump scare,
fucking bear face and shit. So it's always like, I don't get this game.
I never understood it either. Ben, I don't understand what water drop followed by Z's is. I don't know what that is. Put that in our chat. Water. What does it mean to you? A water drop and then Z's we're putting him to sleep, but we're making him wet. Oh, wet dream. What? Nicely done.
You got there. He got there.
You got the wet dream. Nicely done.
Golf clap.
Yeah.
That's like three claps. Unless everybody's doing it, then it's like...
I don't know. I don't know what the...
Not a cacophony. I just
know it's courtesy to just, you know, it's a nice light clap.
Light clap.
And when you talk, you gotta kind of whisper.
They don't do enough slow clap in the movies.
Yeah, it's because it's real awkward to do a slow clap.
It's awkward if it fails.
Yeah, it's true. See, you're the only one doing it.
Yeah, if you're like, you start it up and then nobody fucking joins in.
Yeah.
Yeah, at that point it's like, I'm just going to leave.
It's probably like that at a swinger party too. If you're the only one and nobody joins in, it's getting weird.
Well, it's just bopping the Pope.
The what?
Handing out some literature.
Oh, okay, got it.
Yeah, taking things into your own hands.
For beating off. Got it.
Yes.
Got it. Being the swordsman. I like it.
I like some of the ones are hilarious. You know, pull one, like when they pull.
Yeah.
You know,
rubbing a tug.
Yes. Just jerking off. Playing with my tallywhacker. There's a guy.
Mm-hmm.
Tallywhacker. Who put those two words together? I think they should get like a Nobel Prize, a Peace Prize.
It sounds like it came somewhere from Europe. Tallywhacker. That sounds very UK.
Yeah. You know, it almost even sounds kind of Kiwi. A little New Zealander, maybe?
Okay, yeah. A tally.
Tally.
Tally whacker.
You'll come waltzing Matilda with me. Remember that song? You ever hear that?
I thought that was Irish.
No. Waltzing Matilda is really? South African, yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's about a game warden who comes across this poacher, and they're all like, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. And then the poacher gets killed. It's a sad song.
Did they take his ivory?
No, not that kind of poacher. They don't like have big tusked animals in South Africa, I think.
Well, it's Africa, you know. I mean, I just figured they...
Well, they do. You know, I totally misspoke. And it's like this goddamn caffeine I've been drinking that Brenda got me hooked on. This coffee, and I got a Yeti. I'm all over the fucking place. That's right. That's how
and
I roll.
You claimed you put ice in this son of a bitch and it lasted... Over a day?
Yeah, over a day.
That's fucking crazy.
I think it was like a good 36 hours, because by then I'm like, oh, fuck, so cold, and I just drank it.
It's like magic.
Girls would be like, ew, that's gross. That's like from yesterday. Yeah, but it's from yesterday. What are you doing? Don't drink that.
We're just going to group all women into one collective...
No.
I hate just, day-old ice group.
Just the ones in my sphere of influence.
Would you say that's a big sphere, or is it shrinking? Is it right where you want it, like a medium-sized sphere?
It ebbs and flows.
It ebbs and flows.
Yeah.
And by design? Or no. It just happens that
There's just an organic flow to it.
Some would say your circle of influence is breathing.
It could be interpreted as breathing, yes. Sure.
Okay.
See how I didn't say yes.
Yeah. It's very lawyer-esque.
I know, man. I'd be a good fucking lawyer.
Yeah. Are you still beating your wife?
Yeah,
that's fucking...
When did you stop beating your wife?
Yeah, it's like ask them trap questions you can't answer without being fucked. fucked right up.
When did you realize you were a homosexual?
Yeah, exactly. Like, what the hell? Yeah. Anything?
And then you just fuck with them. You know, you're like, oh, dude, it was the 80s. Everybody sucked dick at least once. Some just keep going. So what? What's the problem here? You never sucked a dick in the 80s. Is everybody, that what you're telling
everybody's
me?
Everybody's a little gay, right? Come on, just look, a little gay.
Almost everybody's going to at least lean over the fence a little bit and go, mm-hmm. Oh, that's not anything I like. No.
Yeah.
I mean, I could appreciate it, but you just go, no, no. It's like when you're squeezing fruit. It's like, no. I'm just not into the papayas.
Mm-hmm.
And then you go...
Or the plantains.
Or the plantains. Plantains I like cooking with, but I remember I made the mistake once of...
Bitter bananas. Fuck that.
Trying to eat one like a banana.
Ugh.
And I think at the time I was not drunk, nor was I unhindered.
Sure.
Right? And so I'm like, oh, it's just like a fucking banana, man. I'll just fucking eat it.
Yeah.
And...
Not.
Have you ever tried to peel a plantain?
No.
Like when you're... Not drunk, and you're sober.
Even kind sober, of. I've never yeah. tried to peel a plantain.
Yeah, it's like a really just unwielding banana. Like, no. It's like not a Bill O'Reilly no. It's like a real no.
Oh, it's, yeah.
But
yeah.
I peeled it anyway. It took about 10 minutes. And then I bite into it, and it's just like, because while I'm peeling it, I'm noticing, it's like, wow, that banana's pretty firm.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yeah. It should be breaking
it's
by now.
It's not the same consistency.
And if I can bite into it, it's like, huh, it's like. Sure, it's like sugar cane, goddammit.
Mm-hmm.
Not really that tense, but...
No. Or sweet. I don't know. Something about a
sometimes,
plantain.
Sometimes you can get them sweet, but
I've
rare.
Only ever cooked with them, but yeah, it was, I'm not a huge fan.
They're fun to caramelize with the browns
of
sugars.
There you go. To add yes. the sugars.
Add yeah. the sugars.
Add the sugars. So today is... What is fucking today's date?
19th
of
yes.
July, 2017. We will not... be having a podcast next week because
we've been called to the XL Energy Center next Wednesday night. We're gonna go see Roger Waters.
Well, he called for us. He's a huge fan of the podcast.
Oh, he loves the podcast.
He needs us to come out there, and
I'd like you to come out and see me play.
Yes,
if you don't mind. Was that
good? Was that a good Roger Waters?
I don't know. I'm assuming it was.
Oh, come on, you like Roger Waters?
Yeah, I like Roger Waters. I just don't know exactly.
Well, did
his voice isn't coming to me right
did,
now. His singing voice is, but not his.
Tell me true.
Okay.
Tell
yeah.
me why.
Yeah. So that is a good.
Was line. Jesus crucified?
Yeah. So we're gonna be there.
Yes. See, now I just literally was thinking to myself, "Hey, man, it'd be cool if we went and listened to the Final Cut right now." No, mm-hmm. Dude, you're on the air. You can't do that. And I'm like, "Fuck, guys, shut up! I'm on the air."
Yeah. This is why we don't let you outside.
It's all in my head.
Only at night.
Everybody has voices in their head. I don't give a fuck who they are or what they say. Everybody has. And, you know, maybe they just all sound the same to where it sounds like one fucking voice. But everybody does.
The key is to get them to sing in tune.
Harmony, yeah. Like some Seven Bridges Road shit.
We got we got Daniel chiming in. My ex loves him. I'm guessing that's Roger Waters, and saw him a couple weeks ago.
Oh, cool. Caught him on the tour.
That's the one we're going to.
Yeah. Like, we'll kind of indirectly share the same space.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because she was there,
mm-hmm.
So she saw him. So when they get here, some of their saw him might be left on there still.
Yeah.
And we might
human
get some of that
or
on
poop
us.
Particles or
just,
something
yeah,
like
just, you know, yeah. A little bit of me, a little bit of you, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm looking forward to it. I've
fuck,
never,
it's going
to
be
never
awesome.
Seen him live.
Roger,
you've never seen him, right?
I've never seen him live. I've watched a video of him live, and he was almost outdone by that fucking guitarist who plays the right-handed guitar upside down,
like yeah.
Jimi Hendrix style.
Jimmy.
And he looks bored while he's doing it, and he sounds fucking great. And I'm just like, God, I fucking hate you so bad. Oh, I sounded like Bill Clinton there.
Yeah.
I want to hate you so bad, but you got such good weed.
But he didn't inhale.
He lied like a son of a... Look at his eyes.
Yeah, I know.
You can tell he was a professional stoner.
And he was real good at the lawyer stuff, too, because I didn't have sexual relations with that woman. Define sexual relations. Well, you know, using a cigar as a dildo.
Or treating a girl as a humidor.
Yeah. Yeah.
However you want to look at
exactly,
it, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I like it.
Just one's a little more humid.
Yeah. He says the tickets were expensive. Ben chimed in with magma. What? Aguma? I don't know what the fuck that means. And she cried. Wow.
Wow. That's cool.
That is cool.
We're looking forward to it then, man.
Yeah.
Fucking yeah. Brenda got got me a pair of tickets for the birthday, and she said she didn't want to go because she said...
That's crazy. Why would she not want to go?
Because she didn't think she would enjoy it as much as she thought Aaron would enjoy it. That's some killer shit right there.
I appreciate it. Absolutely.
Yeah.
It was very cool.
It's going to be cool. Looking forward to it. We'll probably be happy, sad, because Roger Waters is like, you know, happy, sad music. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm so glad I'm alive, but I'd feel the same way if I died.
Mm-hmm. Like, this is nice, and then, oh, and this is nice, oh. Then we'll talk about the war for a few hours, too, probably.
Yes, yes. Let's see, what's new? What's going on out in the world?
Well, the big Mayweather-McGregor fight went on a four-city world tour.
Oh, God, that's such a shit show.
Absolute shit show. Some of the funny lines, though, McGregor looking Mayweather in the eye as they're doing their first face-off, and he said to him, because Mayweather he's broken his hands numerous times. He's got very brittle hands, so whenever he fights, he demands that they wear really big gloves. Mm-hmm. And he looks at him, are your hands cold, laddie? Your hands hurt, laddie? Do they get real, real hurt in the cold? Do you moisturize them?
Hold on one second.
Yeah.
Mayweather's hands are broken.
Yeah, and McGregor is telling him, yeah, he's like,
okay.
Oh, are your hands okay,
laddie? Okay, I get it now.
Do they hurt when it's cold?
Wow.
It was really great. And then McGregor's coming from an MMA background, right?
Right, right.
He's looking at me going, don't worry, if this was a real fight, you'd be dead already. We'll put enough rules in place to keep your boy alive here.
Yeah, it's great. And the thing is, I just hope he brings it.
Yeah.
Because is this a straight boxing match? I mean, this isn't...
It is a straight boxing match. Sorry, I was reading, but yeah. It's a straight boxing match. So Mayweather's heavy favorite. Because he's one of the best defensive boxers, if not the best defensive boxer of all time. He's good at not getting hit. He's only been knocked down, not out, down once in his career. He's fought 49 times professionally. He's 49-0.
That could be cool. Now, when is that fight take
August
place?
August 26th.
Why they got why so far away? Just so they could make money pushing it?
Yep, so this gets hype for it.
Because there's probably people who tune into some of these channels, man, just hoping to see the commercial. I bet there's some.
Yeah, well, they not sold out four arenas for this world tour. Staples Center... Canada.
God, think about some. How much were tickets for that? Do you know?
To go to the fight? Shit.
No.
They were cheap tickets to go, but they sold out every venue they went to. One of which was like the big arena in London, New York.
Really?
That was Madison Square. I think they sold out in New York.
That's awesome.
That's fucking nuts. Just to see these two square off and talk shit.
Talk shit for
25, 30 minutes.
Wow. So what do you think it was like, $25?
Yeah, something like that, probably.
So if it's $25, and how many people they get in those arenas?
I don't know. It depends.
I mean, a lot.
Like, it's a fucking stadium.
Yeah, so like we're talking 10,000?
Oh, more than that.
20,000?
Probably around there.
Yeah. 20,000 fucking people.
Yeah.
Wow.
Just to watch them, you know, fuck around for a bit. That fight, the tickets for the fight are going to be very expensive. And
it's weird.
The betting lines are a little closer than I thought they would be, considering McGregor has zero professional boxing experience.
What? Just out of curiosity, what makes McGregor think that he can actually do this against a seasoned upright fighter?
I don't know. He's a very confident guy.
I don't mean that in a slam at all. Yeah, it is upright boxing. That's upright fighting.
Most people are coming at it the same way you are. Like, what the fuck are they doing? It's a money fight.
In order to get
Mayweather to fight, you have to pay him $100 million. He's getting $100 million just paycheck to do the fight, and then he's going to make a bunch of other money on the side because of sponsorships, ticket sales, all that shit. Pay-per-view buys.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Do you think we could get a poor stadium tour for the show?
Oh, absolutely. You know, they're both fans of ours, of course. Ben says he's going to put his money on McGregor. Odds are good. That's crazy, dude. Floyd Mayweather? Ugh, I don't know, man. Floyd is 40, and Conor's like 26 or 27.
Conor could take a punch, too.
Yeah, with MMA gloves. You know what I mean? So these boxing gloves aren't going to knock you out as easy as the MMA gloves.
Yeah, that's going to be some glass chin shit right there.
Don't be surprised if he beats Floyd. McGregor will fight from the outside. Yeah, he does have a little bit longer reach. He's a taller, bigger guy. Floyd's fought bigger guys. Floyd's small, but he's so fucking fast.
Dude, can you imagine the fucking upset if...
That would be probably one of the biggest. I'd say it's definitely... I think it's under the 1980
Yeah, because it'd be
hockey Olympics. But
it'd be crazy if Mayweather went down.
Do you remember when Mike Tyson fought Buster Douglas in boxing?
I'm moving it.
Yeah, no, go for it. I don't care. The Buster Douglas was, I think they're saying, was it 200-1 or something? Or it was crazy. Buster wasn't even supposed to be close in that fight.
Really?
And Mike Tyson comes out, knocks him down in the first round. Mike Tyson looks like he's just going to walk to victory. And then Buster Douglas decided, fuck this. I'm not letting this guy bully me around the ring. And he went right at him and knocked him out and won. Took the belt from him.
Serious?
Yep.
Wow.
So
it doesn't pay to be cocky.
It's fucking possible. But those guys are both boxers. And Conor McGregor, boxing is one of like the six mixed martial arts that he has to know, or one of the six martial arts.
Well, is he as good at each one of them as Mayweather would be? You know what I'm saying?
If they fought in an octagon?
Oh, yeah.
I would give Mayweather's chances lower than McGregor's chance in a boxing ring. Because here's the deal. Mayweather would go in there, one leg kick, and he would drop to the ground. If the fight went to the ground at all, he would be choked out within 10, 15 seconds. He has no idea how to do anything except boxing. Where Conor, boxing is one of the many things he has to work on. So he's capable.
So Mayweather's more, all his energy goes to boxing, whereas he's dividing his energy.
Boxing's crazy. Your stance is completely different. You can have this wide stance because you don't have to worry about getting kicked in the legs or being taken down. So you can stand in front of a guy pretty close, widespread legs, and sit there and duel with them. You don't get kicked. You don't get taken down. In MMA, you can't do that. You got to be on your fucking feet all the time.
Moving and shaking. Moving and shaking.
Keeping good distance, yeah.
Well, it'll be interesting because, like I said, I mean, as much bullshit that he's been talking, if he loses, it could be bad for him.
Who, McGregor?
Yeah.
This is a no-lose fight for him. He's supposed to get worked. He's supposed to get worked by Mayweather. Mayweather is supposed to just walk all over him.
Basically, okay, here's what's going on then. So these guys are coming up, they're coming to our TVs and radios, and they're saying, okay, man, hey, check this out. Mm-hmm. We got these two dudes, right? We're going to get them to beat the shit out of each other, right? And if you'll pay us, we'll like put it on TV.
Yep.
And it's basically they're just getting these guys, you know, I know it's commerce, and that's what they're out to make money. I get that. But still, just the hype that they do and the fervor that happens because of it, you know, it's fascinating.
It's a lot of hyping up the fight. I mean, they're going to get boxing fans because Mayweather, he's undefeated.
Right. But
and
look,
they're going to get MMA fans now. So,
yeah, it's.
They're predicting 4 point some million pay per view buys. And that pay per view is not $60, it's $100.
And what are they looking at?
They're looking at the record is 4.6 million pay per view buys. They're looking to break that.
Wow.
So, yeah, $100 a pop.
That's money out of thin air right there, man.
Yeah.
Has money out of thin fucking air.
Throw $100 on McGregor and make them odds. Ben's a big better. Ben, what? You don't bet on that shit. You roll them dice. He's a big craps guy.
Oh, I love craps, man. Craps fucking rocks. It took me 20 years to actually figure out all of the board as far as functionality and that shit. You know, I'm still get it. Motherfucker, you do keep moving on me. See, I'm like, why does this keep? I pull it up. It's like a dream.
Just move it. Fuck
like
it.
No, like those dreams, you know, where you can't run.
Like and there's like, a bear running across the floor.
And if you or a snake.
Or a snake.
Terry cloth, like okay. A. Fucking, see, now that I'm going to have the dreams again.
That's all right. Just dream about craps. A funny story about Ben and craps. We're at his wedding, which is in Las Vegas.
Which only makes sense.
I don't know what night it was. It was one of the drunken nights we're stumbling around. And we go to a craps table, and it's kind of rude etiquette in craps when you're the dice roller. The second they give them to you, to just roll right away.
Right.
Because people got to get their bets on the table, right? Give them a chance to get their bets on the table and then roll, right?
Right. So,
Ben is sitting there fucking the dude rolling the dice. He's hold on a goddamn second, just drunk. Just
Ben
drunk
said that.
Oh yeah, that's great. And the guy got the hint, you know. But I think Ben, I think he lost big that night. So maybe he
craps is a beautiful lady, man. Yeah, and sometimes she fucking comes through on prom night, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Other times she doesn't, and you got to pay for that limo.
That's why you got to bring a decent amount of money with you. For me, if I'm doing craps, 300 is the minimum because you're pretty safe. You know how to bet,
right?
To at least break even,
right?
So, unless you're really fucking unlucky,
yeah, I love playing that backside, man. playing those numbers in back.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because that's where Lady Luck's like, man, you sure? I don't think I'm going to break your heart, man, but baby, baby, this might happen.
Yeah, but I'm not even going to try and talk on it because fucking Ben is...
No, it's fun. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is. It's funny. It's all betting on a fucking dice roll.
But yeah, it is. But you're betting on the odds, you know, and then you're even looking at the trends. You know, as you're watching the dice, you're watching those rolls, you know, you're kind of putting those trends in your head.
It's what you do with your winnings too, like, because it's crazy game. You got to know when to reach and grab your shit.
Yeah, you got to know when to pull stuff out
and where to re-put it.
What's crazy is how those motherfuckers work in the table.
I know. There's so many hands.
There's like so many hands. There's so many piles. And they're like, okay, this goes here. This goes here.
No.
It's like, are they all like?
Uh-oh, where was this going?
Yeah. Rain Man.
Oh, got it. Yeah, it was. Craps is fun though. Yeah, it's. The one table game I like. I don't mind blackjack, but the problem is if you're on a blackjack table with... The beautiful thing about craps is other people's bets can't fuck yours up. Where in blackjack, if people don't know what they're doing and the dealer flips over one of their two cards, right? And you see it's called a bust card. Chances are they're going to bust. And they got people hitting on shit they shouldn't be. It fucks the whole board up, right? Hmm. Where in craps, it doesn't.
Right.
So,
you know, my favorite gambling style game, though, is definitely... poker.
Like, poker? Like Hold'em? Yeah. Hold'em is fun.
Love playing Hold'em.
I suck at it. I'm good up to heads up. Shit, that's another story with Ben. This fucking every fucking poker game I'd make it to the heads up play and just get murdered. My heads up play is awful, but I can get pretty far.
Well, is it awful because you get intimidated?
No, it's awful because when you're in heads up play, depending on your chip size, the aggression level changes completely. So hands you would fold before with a bunch of people on the table, you wouldn't necessarily fold heads up. Posturing up is a hell of a lot easier because...
You're just one-to-one.
One guy. You don't have to worry about the three other people on the table, where if I posture up on this guy and they have pocket aces, they just kind of, oh, okay, I'll call you. Fuck.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah. That's a good idea, right?
Yeah.
They don't all sound like that, though.
No. Well, some do.
I've watched some of the poker tour guys. I like when they're at the last hand, you know, and it's like that last fucking hand, they're all like, fucking all in, man.
Yeah.
And then it's always one of them who just, sometimes two, but usually one of them gets up, he's like walking around with his hands folded.
Well, that's very common now.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, but at that point, you know, you're walking away with something big because you're second place.
So. Yeah, I think right now there's the big tournament's going on, the main event out in, I think it's Vegas. How many are left? 40 or so people. And it's $10,000 to enter, or you can win it by winning online satellites. But right now, if you were to go out, you would make $250,000. If you're on the final table, everybody on the final table is automatically a millionaire. So it's crazy. If you're part of the nine that are left on the final table, because of what place you're in, everybody on there is now a millionaire. Fuck. Ninth place makes $1 million. So... Yeah.
So you just got to get good enough to get to that table.
There's so many people who join that tourney. I mean, it takes luck, but it also takes skill. You have to know.
So what you're saying is you don't believe in yourself, boy. You ain't got no spirits.
I'll tell you what, I would not want to sit there and play poker 10 fucking hours a day. I mean, that would be awful. If you're doing it right.
Well, like, but it's
very mentally draining.
You got to think about it though, man. You got to think the ends could justify the means. How long do you do that for? How long would that be?
A tournament like that? Shit, I don't know how long. I would say like a week before the nine, or before it's down to nine, if not longer than that.
And at the very least, you would get $1 million?
If I knew I was going to get $1 million.
No. I meant in the top nine. Yeah. But so at the very least, if you hit the top nine, you get $1 million.
I think the winner gets like 9 or 12 million or something somewhere in that.
This is what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
That'd be worth it for a week.
Well, of course you knew you were going to do that, of course.
Well, you don't know you're going to get there. You're hoping you're going to get there. But just that idea, if you had the money, if you had the money to get in on it, just to fucking go for it. I mean, yeah, it's going to be a grueling fucking, you know, 70-hour week, 80-hour week playing fucking poker. But
I think you play on the weekends, too. I don't think it stops until they're down to nine, and then they cut them off until November. So they get a break to do whatever they want, and then they come back.
Because you'd have to practice that kind of shit. I mean,
imagine they would.
Because that goes beyond just playing poker. Because there's endurance now.
Yep.
You know, you've got to learn how to pace yourself. People pace myself. I'm just sitting there. It's like you don't understand. There's still things going on while you're sitting there. You a toe tapper? That expends energy. You know, do you do? Are you a fidgeter?
And you have to constantly think about what you're doing with your face when you get good cards versus when you don't. Because it's crazy. Some of the pros, they are really good at reading body language. They are really good at reading your face and the way you put your chips out. It's nuts how often they're right. Like, I bet this guy is, like, king high. Fucking dead on. It's crazy.
Really?
It's a fucking skill, man. It really is.
Oh, yeah. That's a profession. Yeah. If that's your profession, you better fucking have that shit down to a science. Saw the Blade Runner trailer tonight.
Yes, that was really cool. I barely remember the first one, I'll be honest.
Yeah, me too.
That's his favorite movie of all time.
Yeah, trust me, it's imprinted in my fucking skull.
So, with what you've seen in the two trailers, does it seem like it's bringing some of the old in and keeping the story going?
Yeah, it does appear that they are hitting the mark. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I remember when they show the cities, they're not just showing the same city. They're showing a city of that caliber that has evolved. Because you've seen some of like the holograms and some of the stuff they're doing. You know, it's like, because they had that kind of stuff in the original Blade Runner. But this is like what it would be like 30 years later.
Crazy.
Yeah. So
I always liked that about
Blade Runner. They had to envision that, you know.
I liked how the era it came out in, it wasn't all CG. Like
right.
They built this Shit. Place that seemed, no, you're right. It seemed real. It was like a future that I could understand and like, oh, shit, that could happen.
Yeah.
Like in some of the structures.
You know, and it holds up.
Yeah.
The only thing that's missing, really, is cell phones. Wireless telephones.
Oh,
They didn't have those. Because remember, when he's at the bar.
Right.
The snake pit. He had to use a phone. You know, AT&T, and it was like $3, $2 and... I think it was $1.73 for the long distance call. I remember the audience is like, everyone laughed.
Yeah.
Because you know, at the time you were paying, you know, just dirt cheap shit.
That's crazy. Yeah. They always get stuff wrong. But Ben asks, who's playing Harrison Ford? Well, Harrison Ford is playing Harrison Ford.
Yeah. It's like,
what's his character's name?
Deckard.
Thank you. God. Sorry.
Sorry.
I always get that mixed up because there's a dude in Diablo called Deckard Cain.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So, he's playing himself as Deckard.
Yep. He's like back in the 90s, there was, do you remember Lee Jeans had a mascot, Buddy Lee?
Oh, shit, I
Buddy
do.
Lee. Yeah, it's like Buddy Lee presents a Buddy Lee production starring Buddy Lee in Buddy Lee.
Wasn't he always like wearing like a,
yeah,
like
he
a red
Yeah, red stripes, checkered, yeah. Because like I've got that magnet on the cabinet at work. Shit.
Fucking
and it's like,
Buddy Lee.
It's a little picture, and he's just this little doll they'd put in different places, and Buddy Lee would just do all kinds of crazy shit.
Yeah.
Buddy Lee knows dynamite is dangerous. Close up on his face. Buddy Lee knows he doesn't care. And then it's like, and they blow him up.
Nice.
It's like, that's good. Crazy stuff. I could have thought about that and made fucking money too, but I didn't. I get angry. I get envious. Yeah, I'm envy.
Buddy
one
Lee.
Of the seven. One of the seven right there.
That's right.
I'm envious of that doll.
I'm gluttonous of that doll.
Oh, you ate the doll?
I ate him, yeah. Buddy Lee's.
Buddy Lee's. And you look like one of them turtles that die with all the fucking plastic in their stomach.
Oh.
Bummer. Yeah, I know. Bummer or boner?
Yes, absolutely. I have to get sad to get a boner. You didn't know this?
I mean, I like stripper when she's crying, you know.
Ooh,
I mean,
ooh.
Yeah,
just
that's
the strippers.
See, I just went one step down, just
wow
from you. I just lowered myself.
Really? I don't know. I don't know what that was. It was a weird thing.
I heard. Dun. I know.
We have random reverb sounds happening in this place.
It was frightening, but it's okay now. What other movies?
We survived.
What other movies?
So we saw a trailer for, was it The Snowman?
Yes,
that looked really cool.
Yes,
actually.
The Snowman. It's a story, serial killer detective. I'm gonna catch you. I'm gonna kill more. You know that one. But it looks fucking awesome.
Looks like he sends messages. He's always fucking with the cops using snowmen.
Yeah, he'll put like victims' heads on a snowman or a snowman's head on the victim, like where the head's on the snowman.
And
anyway,
sometimes we'll take the snowman's carrot and do crazy things with it. And
it's like, that's not the fruit locker. Mm-hmm. Sorry.
Fruit locker? Carrot's not a fruit, is it?
Well, that's where we put it.
Oh, jeez. Help. We need help.
There was that movie, Water. Made in Water.
Something like that. It's a Guillermo del Toro movie.
But it's
not like horror.
It's not like horror, but it's kind of, you know, it's kind of E.T.-ish.
We could explain it to you, but it's tough. Like,
it's about this chick who's a mute, and she gets a job working at this lab, and then she's really good at what she does, so they have her cleaning up in the secret lab, and then there's this tank in there, and there, she meets this fish dude, and he's really nice to her, and everybody else is like dicks and shit. So she's not supposed to talk to him, but they do, and she kind of falls in love with this little fish dick dude. And then, yeah.
We're really selling this, man. This should be the
talking
point.
I could pitch this shit,
fish
man.
Fishman likes mute girl.
Mute girl likes fish man, too.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
I like it.
There should be some pickle herring going on tonight if you'd get my drift. Oh, my God.
Pickled herring, huh? Oh, make fishball soup. Fishball.
No, it just hit the hopper.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, I got to say that. Okay, I'll say that.
Yeah, it's generally how I describe your brain. It's like, You're just a send and receive. You don't decide what comes out and what stays in. It just kind of, your brain feeds it to you. And like, I don't want to say that. But more's coming. You got to shove it out.
So it'd be like a conveyor belt of random things from Goodwill.
That's why randomly he'll just say like dick nipples. I'm like, dick, what happened? Well, I was talking nipples. About a dick. And then my brain pushed nipples out with it. I got a week.
I got to redo some of the code.
I got a week O-ring. It just all comes out together.
Yeah, I just... I got
This movie sounds like dick. That's what we got from the chat.
Sphincter.
This movie sounds like dick.
Yes.
Yeah.
Dick. There was a movie called Dick about two girls in Nixon. That's all I know about it.
Two girls, one Nixon?
Yeah, I don't think it was like that, but I mean, it could have been.
Oh.
It is possible.
That would Things. Be interesting. Do they shit on him? Because that'd be great.
See? Isn't this crazy that you're going places I usually go but chose not to go tonight?
But it's not shit. They just piped a bunch of moose in their asses.
And actually, that's what they did.
Allegedly, yeah.
But still.
Yeah.
That's what's hilarious. Because I love the looks you get from fucking people, or I get from fucking people, when I say, no, it's not shit, man. They just pipe moose up their ass.
It's completely different.
And then they look at you like...
Now it's just moose with random bits of corn and nuts, right?
I know.
It's great.
But they just give you that look because they're trying to equate it. They're trying to quantify it.
Yeah.
But it's just like gears grinding together.
It's not like they were sitting there eating shit. They were just eating moose that happened to be in the same area of shit.
No, they clean out really good. They use Pine Sol.
I knew it because I've only seen a little bit of it. I'm like, I'm done with this.
But the reaction videos.
Oh, my God.
Those are the best.
It was a fucking moose poop Kano. I was like, oh my God.
I mean, I still do like moose, though.
I'm not a big fan of moose. I wasn't before, and I'm not really.
Love chocolate mousse. I used to make it. Have to make it literally from fucking scratch back in food service days. I was pretty good at it. That souffles, making fucking awesome sauces and shit, fucking compotes. Put that shit on your fucking souffle, bitch. Eat that shit.
Did you ever add some homemade mayo to your...
No.
Okay, good. You're not one of those chefs?
No.
Good. You don't fuck
that's
with
no
that's
no
bullshit.
No, that's bad fucking karma.
Yeah.
Now you can't fuck with the guy's pop though. Yeah. in the kitchen you can
oh,
you can
God.
We used to guys have their drinks, you know, we'd in glass because it was the 80s, fucking live on the edge.
Yeah.
You take the straw out of the drink and you dip it in like Lee and Perrins or Tabasco or whatever your dick was feeling that day, and then you put it back in there. Yeah.
Cover it up
and they're drinking, and then they're very unhappy when they come for a drink. It's not exactly what they planned, and and you could ruin a motherfucker's night.
Well,
I mean,
absolutely.
You can. I mean, because fucking a mouthful of Worcestershire sauce. You'd rather take a shot from a random guy on a hockey team
when you're expecting like Coke. You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck? Yeah, that's so bad. No, man, Ben says, no, man, the girls don't eat for 24 hours and use enemas.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm sure. But, well, yeah, I get how they do that. But you can't tell me there's just a little remnants. Like we went in there with a fucking CSI DNA kit or something like that. Oh, look, it's glowing. There's one.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
That's how it would go.
How much money would you have to get paid to pipe when they come up and they're pitching this idea to them? Listen. we want you to, no, there's not going to be any like porn, or you're not going to touch each other, but here's what we need you to do. Don't eat for 24 hours. Come in, and then we'll discuss the rest. So they come in all malnourished, and they're like, listen, we're going to pipe a bunch of moose up your ass.
But first, we're going to give you some enemas.
Yeah, yeah. And then you're going to eat it.
And no, not the enema.
No, that's no. God, filthy. That's disgusting. How dare
no,
you?
No, we're gonna pipe moose up your ass, chocolate yeah. moose, and then you guys are going to shit it out, and people think it's shit, but it's not. It's moose, so it's really good to eat, and you guys are going to like eat it and rub it all over your bodies.
You think anybody at one point in time or another would ask, who the fuck wants to watch this?
Why would you film yourself fucking a horse? Once.
I don't think he made it, right? Yeah. No. What's his name? Goatsy or something?
No, no. That's another thing altogether different. Yeah, just educate the masses. Someone out there, what's Goatsy? Just look it up on your computer. Just search for G-O-A-T-S-E and hit search and then click on images.
Ben's got the, it's a whole lot of meth. That's how you pipe a bunch of moose up your ass and get paid to do it because you're...
But those girls look thick.
Do they? I don't remember them looking thick.
Well, I don't... See, that humor thing that I do sometimes that I think I'm funny, but I'm really not, almost came out again.
Like the hip new, like, it's not really new, but hip, thick, like T-H-I-C-C. That girl's thick.
Thick. Yeah.
It's like...
I know, honestly, I'm not good at it. I shouldn't do it.
That replaced fat. P-H-A-T from like the late 90s.
Well, but that was good because fat needed to go.
Yeah.
P-H-A-T was, it's like, look what you did to my fucking couch. All right?
Yeah.
It has a bow in it now and it's got fucking.
You're referring to an actual thing that happened.
Chip grease all over it.
You're referring to a thing that actually
no,
happened.
No, I'm just making that shit up.
Yeah.
No, that didn't happen, really. Things have happened in my life, but that was not one of them.
Yeah.
See, I'm trying to think of a. So I'm trying to make sure the stories I don't tell.
Yeah, he's got a lot of stories that we cannot bring up on here.
Well, and it's not a statute of limitations thing or anything like that.
Well, we work with people, and some stories you probably don't want the world to know.
Well, it's nothing bad. I mean, I'm not like Harrison Ford and The Fugitive.
We got Mr. Dewclaw coming in. We know who this guy is.
Well,
Dick Nipples brand enemas. I think this is a winner.
Wow.
Well, thank you, Mr. Dewclaw. I agree.
I think we could go with that. Dick Nipples.
Dick Nipples.
Dick Nipples.
It'd be a good name.
That'd be a great name.
Richard Nipples, but my friends call me Dick.
But your name is...
Richard Nipples, but my friends
call me Dick. It'd be like N-E-U-I. And then, you know, so it's a Nibo. No, Nipples.
No, it's Nipples.
It's Nibo. Nipples.
Nipples.
Your name is Dick Nipples. You just fucking better get used to that.
Yeah. Yeah,
that'd be fucked up.
I still, one of my favorites is your I see your name here. Let's see, Pat Fenis. It's Patrick Fenis. Pat Fenis.
Pat Fenis.
Pat Fenis.
Fenis.
Nah, I'm seeing Pat Fenis here.
I'm sorry, sir.
Yeah,
and I've already started writing. Mr. Dabalina, Mr. Bob Dabalina.
So I just got a ping here from CNN. I just don't like the way this reads. This isn't funny, but I don't. Senator John McCain had a very aggressive brain tumor removed last week, his doctors tell Sanjay Gupta.
Because he's a doctor guy.
Well, just aggressive, like, I don't know why my brain went there, but I'm talking like, this thing's like, I'm not fucking leaving.
No.
We need to get you off of here, dude.
Fuck you and your scalpel. Yeah,
fuck you, huh?
We had a deal.
Yeah.
We had a fucking deal.
He got me in Vietnam. All right. I'm not leaving.
I get to stay here. And then he does this thing where he talks how he can't lift his arms above this high.
You know why he can't do that, right?
Yes, I know. Yeah. But he would appreciate the humor because I really wasn't being disrespectful. I think it was like a Galaxy Quest homage.
Oh, wow.
See?
That's a movie I wish they would have remade.
Oh.
Sucks.
What? What remade? You mean a sequel?
Yeah, I'm sorry, not remake, sorry, sequel. Yeah,
hey, don't freak
they
me out.
They were going to until, what's his name?
Oh, Rickman.
Rickman.
Mr. Rickman. Alan Rickman was such a great fucking actor.
Yeah, he was.
He was fucking phenomenal. I mean, you know, we were pretty much introduced to him. I mean, he'd been around before Die Hard doing things.
That was definitely his big role.
But that was his breakout. That was like, hey, look at me. Omal Bridges, Octa. That was really bad. And he did the Harry Potter shit.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, he was in there.
Snape, yep. Right? Snape. I think that was his name.
I never got into that one.
And
I saw one in the theater, and I was like, this isn't for me.
In my wrong audience. Screenplay, I wrote about Doe, Jane, about the sci-fi detective story in there.
Uh-oh. This is it.
I was reading too far ahead.
This is where it all goes away.
Fuck. Get me back on track.
Okay, so Jane Doe.
Doe, comma Jane.
Joe,
Doe, no, comma Jane. Why did I start telling the story?
I don't know, man.
I got so far ahead, and you know what happened? Uh-huh. I branched off in my head, and I started thinking about the book.
Oh, yours? The one you're writing now?
So I'm like, going here. It's like, the car's still going this direction.
See, we talked about...
I'm just not in it.
Alan Rickman. And then you got to Doe, comma Jane.
I wrote the bad guy in Doe, comma Jane around Alan Rickman. Because he was the geneticist, you know, who was working in collusion with the vice president, because the vice president wanted to be president, but the president was in the way. So him and the geneticist, like, the geneticist wants a war. So he's like, just let's get some wounded soldiers coming down here missing limbs. I'll grow their limbs for free. And then once I'm famous for that, then everybody else gets to pay a lot of money for it. And the vice president's, all right, we got to get the president out of the way. So he gets the president accused of murder and stuff. So
gotcha.
Yeah, it's kind of a
this
fun.
Is something you wrote a while ago?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Jeez.
But Alan Rickman was a geneticist, dude. And he was really fun to write because you could just grab that personality.
Yeah.
You know, especially some of the nuances and some of the just because he had a very unique delivery.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, in everything he did. Yeah. You know who's another one who does that? Gary motherfucking Oldman.
That guy's so underrated.
Jesus Christ.
God, he's good. Yeah.
You know, because you see him like Commissioner Gordon,
mm-hmm.
and then you go and watch The Professional, Leon the Professional.
Yeah.
You know, and he's just fiend. And then, or in...
True Romance? Have seen that one? Which was the one I'm thinking
of? Yeah, he was in True... Like yes, he's True Romance.
Like the dreads.
Yeah, True Romance. There we go. Yeah. He goes, I know I'm pretty. Yeah. And then Fifth Element.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, his
he's
laugh,
still
that,
making
that
good stuff.
Manic laugh that he had was just fucking awesome.
I really liked him in, I think it was a BMW commercial.
Oh, yeah.
It was really well done.
That was with James Brown.
James Brown,
and,
yeah.
Yeah, him.
There's some other famous person in there. I just can't quite put.
Marilyn Manson.
Yep.
And then Clive Owen.
Clive Owen, there we go, yeah.
And Danny Trejo.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Yeah. That's a, and that... on its own, I wish they'd put that out like in a serious format to where you could get it like in 4K, because that it was beautiful. I mean,
look it up on YouTube. The BMW ads, just look at the BMW ad, James Brown.
Yeah, they're fucking phenomenal. Highly recommended. Kid tested, mother approved.
Kicks?
Kid tested, mother approved.
Kicks?
No, I'm
talking. That's the cereal.
I know. I'm just borrowing. It's like it's not a cultural appropriation. It's just a cultural appreciation.
So we got Daniel saying, tell one of his stories. And we got Duclaw saying, love G.O.
I'm just not
I'm guessing that's Gary Oldman. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Thank you
yeah.
for catching us up. It's the Lord's wisdom.
This Duclaw guy just has to abbreviate everything.
It's the Lord's wisdom.
Yeah.
It's his way of teaching you how to read between the lines, to see what may not appear to readily be there.
You're like a creepy oil baron.
No, I want to be an evangelist, a televangelist.
You weren't you like Pentecostal for a while?
Yeah, that was some
you
fun
were good
times.
At it. Yeah,
it wasn't. I was very good at it. Yeah. It was fun, man. Fucking Pentecost. I mean, if you have to be in a fucking religion, why not go where you could fucking get all fucking your endorphins fucking going with just simple thought and fucking dance in the spirit and fucking just trading energy and shit. It's fucking awesome shit.
Yeah.
You know, if you got to throw out some hallelujahs and some hey man, fucking throw it out because it feels good at the time.
Collection money.
Yeah, but you know, you got to go into it knowing what you're going to give, what you're not going to give.
Yeah, that's true.
I was pretty cool. You know, I'd throw a quarter in every Sunday.
Nicely done.
Sometimes.
A shiny one or a rusty one?
Well, if they're rusty, we got a problem.
Yeah.
You know, now oxidized.
There we go.
Well, rust is.
Just dirty. That's right.
It's dirty, filthy. Are we talking filthy. Like truck stop bathroom right under the rubber machine dirty?
Yeah.
Or
absolutely. I like that. It might have a curly on.
Or under that weird metal box they have nailed to the wall in the stalls of the women's bathroom that just has that hatch.
Yeah. There's that one. That's for needles, right?
No. Well, no, I think that's for large amounts of cotton
yeah.
and other textile products yeah. made to absorb.
Mm-hmm.
See how cleanly I said that?
I nicely done.
Cookie. Fucking cookie, man.
Cookie clean?
I want a cookie for knowing things about...
I liked him in The Professional. That must be Gary Oldman. And then he says, F you, which is, you know, we deserve that.
Anyway, thank you.
Thank you for that.
In The Professional, man, he was fucking awesome because when he's walking down the hallway at that one point and he busts that ampule or whatever the fuck it was, I think they said it was like... So you do it for angina pectoris when your heart's like, I love you so much. And you're like, stop loving me so much. And this makes it stop. But then he grabs a gun and just starts saying hello in a very fucking personal way. That chick in the bathtub, boom, so walks down the hallway.
You're going to hate me? Never seen it.
Dude, it's worth it.
Never seen it.
We should watch it sometime.
Yeah.
Would you watch it with me?
I mean.
We would watch it together. It's very good.
Never seen The Professional.
I'll make curry.
Isn't a young...
Frankenstein?
No, that would be Mel Brooks. A young Natalie Portman in The Professional?
Very young.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like a kid, yeah.
12 years old.
Yeah.
I think 12.
Yeah, she's...
Or 13.
That was 12. Like her first movie 13. As a kid that kind of got her into the big...
Because 12 or 13 means there's a big gap there in Tennessee.
That's true. Yeah, I wasn't saying, God, she's so hot when she's 12.
No, I didn't think you were. I was just making a correlation.
I appreciate
that. Wow, you got some guilt in there.
Yeah.
Being kind of defensive.
God, she was so hot when she was 15.
she's a beautiful girl, period.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
She is. Is she still pregnant? Does she have the baby?
She's still pregnant.
She was on like Fallon or something like that, or maybe Kimmel.
I didn't know she was.
Yeah, well, if you saw her, you'd know.
Well, usually.
No, I mean, she was like one of them like skinny girls. When they get really pregnant, mm-hmm. So like still skinny, but they got this.
Yeah,
it doesn't make that noise.
Well, I hope not.
But it'd be cool if it did.
I'd ask who the father was then. Does she know who the father is?
Tarstar, the Dark Lord of Satan.
Tarstar, the Dark Lord of Satan. Ben said, "Still would smash."
Still would smash.
Nice.
That's very good. I'm fucking laughing right here.
Very good. Yes,
it's very good. So, what else is Trump in the news? No. I think that's enough on that.
Mm-hmm.
We
had another police shooting here in our state of Minnesota.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
Nutty. They're still figuring it out as we go. But
the BCA, they're not saying much. Pretty much all their question is typical tack board shit. You know, it's like reading the employees' rights placard.
Sure.
On the wall. Yeah. You know, but. So, that's a crazy one because I read in the news at one point that they said the squad car didn't record anything either. Is that true? I know their body cameras did not.
In case you don't know what we're talking about, just to start, allegedly at night, this woman had called the cops and needed help with something. She thought something was happening in her alley.
In her alley, yeah. She thought her woman was getting molested.
The cops pull up. She runs to them outside in her pajamas and... I don't know if she startled the cop, but the cop sitting in the passenger seat, she ran up to the driver's side
right.
And he shot across the other cop in there, shot her and killed her. And it's starting to make national headlines now, but not as fast as normal shootings of this caliber.
Were the roles reversed is what you're trying to say?
In this case, let's just call it for what it is, a black cop shooting a white woman.
Versus a white cop shooting a black woman.
Yeah. Or
well, it's just whatever. Like... But, you know,
the race is just involved, even if it's not involved. You know what I mean? It's
well, think about Knoxville, Kentucky, here about, I think, 10 years ago, something like that. There was this suburban, like, white couple, right? Got stuck in the wrong part of town, tried to do a U-turn, asked some guys for direction, and these guys kidnapped these people, took their shit, and then locked them up in this house for like a day or two.
Jeez.
And proceeded to do very bad things to them. I mean, very unpleasant things. Look it up if you want. Knoxville, Tennessee, murder stuff.
Murder stuff.
Okay. Yeah, it was a couple slain.
That sucks.
But the crazy thing about that is if there was a role, because there were three... African-American gentleman and one African-American woman, right, who were arrested and I think eventually convicted of all this. And but if it would have been the other way around, four white guys and a black couple, that would have been, it would have been really, you know, it's funny, is it would have really been big obviously locally in the United States, but not so big in the world. But the other way around, it almost seems like it's bigger in the other side of the world than it is here.
Yeah.
You know, it's like it just that reversal is kind of crazy when you think about it.
Yeah.
Did that make any sense?
Yeah, it does. As the moral of the story is, there's evil on both sides. Skin color has nothing to do with it.
Oh, yes.
So it's easier to write a story and get clicks when it's one way or the other. You know what I mean?
Yeah, black and white.
Yeah, when it's whites killing blacks, it's easier to write that story and get people's attention than it is the other way around. And it's kind of sad that that's the case.
It kind of goes, it kind of plays into just how much of a hypocritical society we really are.
Yeah.
And, you know, we are. I'm guilty. You're guilty. I mean, India, all you fucking people listening, watching. You guys are guilty too. Everybody's guilty of it to some degree.
Yeah.
And I think if we could just embrace, you know what? This is going to sound total, we are the world. But, you know, if we could just, everybody could just embrace each other across the board for what they like, don't like about them. You know, they're just that, broad acceptance.
Yeah, we're not the same.
Yeah, we're not the same. We're all different. We all have isms.
Yeah.
You know, we all have shit that we don't like that we might not say we don't like.
Yeah.
You know?
With the cop shooting here, and this one thing rang home with me, it was our cops are not equipped to handle situations like this. That cop was not equipped to hold a gun.
No.
Startled and he shot across his fellow officer.
Yes. He should be working in the mall.
Yeah, like what the fuck? He shouldn't even have mace.
Oh, you got a point.
Yeah, I mean it's insane. Like you get
he could be a valet.
Yeah.
He'd be, dishwasher.
Whatever. I don't care. What
I'm trying to help the guy. I'm doing some rehabilitation here.
He's not going to have a job after this most
likely. Well, he's got to get a job somewhere.
Yeah. Well, that's true.
Let's just be nice. Be kind. Let's set the example. Okay. Sorry, I rambled there.
It's funny when some of the interviews you have from ex-police officers who left the force, and
like
they realized how...
Force in general?
Just the cops in general. Like
okay.
They left because they realized they were giving these guys guns, and a lot of them are so green that they shouldn't even have a gun. You give them a baton, because by the time you hit a person twice with a baton, you pretty much realize, holy fuck, what am I doing?
Yeah.
And you're not going to kill them.
Well, I guess it depends on who you are.
But the problem is they have to be armed, right? Because there's a lot of scumbags out there with guns, but holy shit.
Well, I think maybe we need a better selection criteria, something novel like that.
Well, the problem is they can't get enough people to join the police force because you got to be a certain kind of fucked up person to want to do that.
Well, you know what I mean? If you think about it too, and the way they so flagrantly kind of throw little bits of money at like police department and that kind of stuff, for the most part, you don't see them really putting the money where it should be so that the police department has everything it needs to combat bad stuff within its own ranks and try and keep the streets clean at the same time. Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. Here's a start.
Give them some money.
How about you teach them unarmed combat? What they learn in police academy is nothing. These guys need to know fucking basic jujitsu. They need to know when they're wrestled to the ground by a perp, how to fucking reverse that and get them in a choke. And guess what? I'm telling you, these guys, it takes a while to do it, but throughout their entire training, and they should keep up with it at all times, if they learn how to do baseline jiu-jitsu, for the majority of the non-armed combat that they would get into, they would easily find their way out of it.
Yes, I would agree with that. Statistics would actually back that statement up.
And Ben brought up he's college-educated first Somali officer in Minneapolis, which people are going to attack the shit out of that.
I know. I had somebody
going to attack that.
As you know, I had somebody send me a link to
something,
one of these sites that had a story on the thing, and I clicked on it, and it was just all vitriol. It's just right-wing extreme.
They're bringing Sharia law in here. And
yeah.
Law. Yeah, Sharia means law. You don't need to call it Sharia law. You just call it Sharia.
Sharia.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or you could say Sharia style.
Yeah.
You'd be okay because it's Sharia law style, right?
Yeah.
Or law style.
They're like basically insinuating that this...
I don't even
know if the guy's Muslim. This Muslim, alleged Muslim cop shot her because she wasn't covered up enough.
Yeah, no, and which is no, yes, because I'm like, he's like, fuck my training, fuck my job.
Yeah,
I just she's I see her shoulder, oh, wrist, ankle, bang.
I put all this time into this just to shoot one white woman. You know, it's like, come on,
Allah would be so happy.
Yeah, sorry. One white woman. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Even Allah's like, you fucked up.
Really, you have one fucking job.
Yeah,
no.
Yeah, it's a touchy situation, and you know what? I was telling you this. There's no winning here. I mean,
no.
Somebody's dead, first off. There's no winning there. But I'm talking any way this case goes, there's no winning here. Because if they let the cop go, the hate for police becomes
greater.
It comes greater. And if they
convict him,
then it's a race thing.
Yep.
Now the black cop gets convicted. How come these white cops aren't getting convicted? And that is a whole other kind of hate. So either way they do this, it's just, I don't think they can win. I mean, society as a whole is going to really jump down this story.
Now, see, I had a funny add-on to that.
Go for it.
No. I'm taking the high road.
Oh, are you now?
Yes. I was talking with the Lord earlier.
Oh, God. Here's Pentecostal John again. Just get it out. Go ahead.
The Lord told me. He told me you've been pulling on yourself again.
Pulling on yourself again?
Sorry, man.
Hallelujah.
That's just funny to say.
Yeah.
The Lord told me you was pulling on yourself again.
Making that religious batter. Good for you.
Yes. Yeah. Communion batter.
Yeah.
Ooh. Now, what was the thing we read today about the, something about the secret fold or the something? God.
What was the pizza?
Yeah,
the pizza, big fold.
The big, but it was.
The bold fold.
Bold fold.
That's what it was. This is pizza joint, and they have this pizza. It's a New York style pizza with pepperonis on it, and they call it bold pepperoni. And they make the big New York ones. You're supposed to fold it. But they call the thing the bold fold. Fold.
And I just...
And we're like two children, so of course we giggled about that.
Oh, God,
tee-hee.
Well, it was funny because you just figure, you know, it's like, you know, like some of the folds where you could find like secret items you didn't know were there.
I try not to get to that point. I'm a large individual.
Ditto.
But, yeah.
But I have read stories on the internet.
I heard stories firsthand from people.
Yeah, it's like...
Well, secondhand, I guess. It might be firsthand.
It's like sometimes, you know... You scrape that stuff out of there and put it on a plate. Someone would just think it's a really strong cheese from like Uruguay or something.
Oh, God. 10 different kinds of mold they didn't know existed. And yeah, it was actually.
It's kind of tart. Yeah. You know, it's a lot.
A buddy of mine who moved away, we used to work with the guy. His wife worked in like a varicose veins, stuff like that. They would get rid of those. And they would also, I think, do some liposuction stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So these obviously big fat people would come in and they were sitting there working on this one lady and they hear this slap on the ground. It was a fucking sandwich. A sandwich fell out of her fat folds. She didn't know there was a sandwich in there with the rest of whatever was in there.
Or she did know it was there because she'd packed it before she got hungry during the procedure.
Yeah.
See? The more you know.
We got Ben chiming in with, that sounds like a puss.
Yes.
There you go.
The timing's off, because I'm...
Yeah, I know. This is a little delayed. It was probably when we were talking about the bold fold.
The bold fold.
The bold fold sounds like a puss.
Oh, it does.
Hopefully it's not spicy like pepperoni.
But kind of like...
Jesus.
Like maybe if it looks like it just got out of a boxing match, you know, you got that swollen eye shut.
Jesus Christ. It's got a swollen eye. Oh, God.
It's just all that puffy.
Yeah. Oh, man.
It's like,
fucking funny.
Claire, she's been at the vacuum again. Sorry. Katie, how many times have we told you?
Yeah.
But, Daddy, it looks so weird.
This cucumber became a pickle. Like, oh, you need to go get checked out.
She's your daughter. You fix her.
You fix her.
I'm going to go pray.
That's a poor choice of words.
You fix her. Well, no, you,
like
kids.
Neuter, spade.
No, not like that. I mean, fix.
Yeah.
Yeah, go get her fixed. That's how you'd use that. That'd have to be enough. I said, gonna go get her fixed. Everyone's gonna know what I'm talking about.
I mean, to ask you about this. This is something like kind of in the same lines, I guess. A couple in Australia gave birth to their child and gave it no gender.
Oh, yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah.
And is there a reason? Was it? Were there parts missing or were there additional parts?
No.
This was all normal.
It was. It has a certain plumbing, but they decided that the kid's going to decide its gender when it's ready.
The child has...
I believe it was a boy.
So he has one gender or another down in his nether regions.
Yeah. He's either got a twig and berries or he's got a...
The cleft.
Or a sword wound.
Or a bloody axe wound.
That's right, yeah. Yeah.
God, I hate being a chauvinist.
No, but it's...
No.
You got to understand gender. You were born one way.
That is ridiculous.
That's not what you are mentally. But if I have a dick and balls, I'm a male. That's what gender is. You are a human male.
You are a human male. Yeah, and it's not a supposition.
You decide to lop that off and become a female, good on you.
But you're still a male.
You can't invent gender.
You can dress. And don't get me wrong, I am not against transgender at all. No, but same. I don't think that there should, if you actually go through all of it to where it's like, you know, your outies now and any, you know, towards like that. Okay, yeah. Now here, bam. Rubber stamp. Yeah. You're a girl now.
Good.
But if you still got the twig and berries, no, just get in there.
You want to identify as anything? You're not hurting anybody.
Yeah.
Just go and do it. Yeah. I
mean, yeah, but the parents, that's like here about a year or two ago, there was this mother who was doing an anti-bullying campaign about her because kids at school were bullying her seven-year-old transgender.
You can't decide. At 7 years old.
I know. That's what I'm trying to say. Because I don't even think the id's there, obviously. It's like, But the ego is like still soft in the middle.
Yeah, at seven, you do things wrong all the time. You do things for the wrong reason.
I mean, that is mom
being
a little fucking attention whore.
Yep. That's like dad deciding my kid's going to be a quarterback and a wrestler. Yeah, no choice.
That's almost some Munchausen by proxy shit right there.
Munchausen, you used a term that I don't know.
Oh, Munchausen by proxy is when you you do shit to your kid to get attention. Oftentimes you're making them, sick, or you might, trying to ride that balance on the sick stuff. So that,
people like Ramsey, where they doll their daughters up and make them do the dance stuff. A lot of times they don't even want to do that crap.
Yes. Yeah. JonBenet.
Yeah.
Sorry.
JonBenet
Ramsey. You just Ramsey.
Yeah. Sorry. Can't remember the
guy in the barn.
No.
I thought that was Stu.
No.
No. I'm a fucking totally against that child pageant shit.
Yeah.
I remember when my daughter was like five, something like that. She was on the ice skating thing, little
the
dance
snowflakes.
Thing.
You can't call them that anymore.
But then
though.
they give them the fucking baby these bathing suits and they. You know, I'm not a prude. You know I'm not a prude. Anybody fucking knows me knows I am not a prude.
And
right? You're
not a pedophile.
No, nor am I a pedophile. But I remember when I saw the fucking first time they were dancing, they're on the ice, and they come out, and they're doing, they're doing a sexy dance, you know, and it's like they're in this little bikini thing. They're you know, and they don't know what they're doing, granted.
Yeah.
But still, it's setting a precedent with the kids. It's like they don't get that because I'm not a Puritan. I'm not a prude. You know, I'm a horny motherfucker. So I get it, but I just don't think that should be introduced to children that young in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah, I would agree.
And I kind of pitched a little bit of a bitch, and they looked at me like I was high.
You probably were. Nice.
But I still let them know that I didn't really approve of that, and I tried to explain why. You know, but they get so caught up. They got that fucking beauty mother or beauty show mother fucking mentality because some of that shit I've watched some of those shows and I've seen it's documentaries awful. And man there's some of these and I'm not Jesus, it's not Ben. A it's not a sweeping generalization but some of these people some of these parents scare me.
Yeah, I agree.
They frighten me.
Ben chimes in scouting for hustler.
Scouting for hustler.
Jesus Christ. Oh man,
this is why
I like you, Ben. You and JP have many things in common when it comes to. I'm just gonna fucking say it. I mean, whatever happens. Nobody's gonna die.
Nobody dies.
Nobody dies.
Did anybody die? No. But you told the president to fuck off.
Yeah.
No.
You said you were going to kill him.
No, I did not. I asked him if he would like a pillow. Sorry.
With chloroform on it.
No, just a pillow, heavy
in front of his face. Right.
Well. Theoretically, allegedly, no.
Yeah.
I wish no harm upon our president on high.
On high. Ooh.
Come on, I'm trying to help. Part of the team. Jumping out there, putting myself out there.
Yeah.
Hit me. We need mouth guards. We should get mouth guards.
When we're talking, just kind of flip. What's going on, man?
When we know it's going to get ugly.
Yeah. Oh, right away, you mean then?
Yeah, we're going to be working on another bit here in probably the next month or so.
Absolutely.
Coming your way, but we're not going to tell you about it, but we're going to tell you it's funny. We think it's funny.
Mm-hmm. Last bit we did was Kitchen Hacks. One before that was...
Which we've gotten some pretty good feedback shorts. On.
Yeah,
we should do some more shorts. We should do some shorts.
Shorts are simple, yeah.
Yeah, because we do, like, well, check out some of our shorts. Cause we got some short fucking shorts. I think there's one that's like 10 seconds long.
Yeah, there's I think there's two of them.
Yeah. DB shorts. DB shorts.
Yeah.
We still have that. We should do more DB shorts.
Sure. It's easy. We just got to come up with something stupid.
Which how about we should
do all the time?
We should have that's not Nutella one.
Oh, gotcha. There you go. That's not chocolate mousse.
Yeah, because what if I'm trying to think of a situation to where the wrong thing would get in a Nutella jar. I mean, what if hypothetically you had to take a sample to the doctor and you had just the cake batter blues, you know, mm-hmm. chocolate cake batter blues, and the only thing you had you just finished your Nutella, so you just fucking dump it and throw the lid on it, and maybe you leave it on the counter, right, while you're changing, getting ready. And then someone comes home. Oh, and I sell it. You come out right after the first bite. You're like, hey, that's not Nutella.
That's nutty and salty. That's nutty and salty. Not good. Or what about you in your Yoo-hoo chocolate?
Yoo-hoo. Oh, Yoo-hoo is good stuff, man. You get that out of the fucking pop machines.
Mm-hmm.
Because I remember when I was a kid, we had these pop machines that had bottles in them. Not plastic bottles. Wow. So you'd like put your money in. And then you'd open the door. Have you ever seen one of the old fashioned?
I have actually. Yeah.
And you'd pull it. It was all mechanized. Mechanized.
Yeah.
But I always thought it was crazy that this quarter goes down. It hits a little spring that tricks this, that tricks that, that trick. And each thing that gets tricked gets bigger and bigger and bigger until it's like pretty soon you're like,
yep.
Pulling your bottle out. And you'd always try to pull two out at the same time. You never get it.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, because I guess there was so much play in the entire mechanism.
Yeah.
Because we pull really hard.
Oh, you still do.
No. Well, how many times a day, though?
Ha ha!
The numbers are down.
Yeah.
Don't hurt my feelings.
Now, Yoo-Hoo, I think it's still around. It is. And then Ovaltine.
Yes, they are. I love Ovaltine.
And then Ovaltine's like Nestle good. Quick.
Like Ovaltine, as well as Nestle's Quick.
Nestle's Quick, yeah.
Really fun to put on your ice cream.
Just in powder form, really.
Fuck yeah. Cool. And then you put it in the microwave for about like 10 seconds, get a little bit of melt
like
on
that.
It.
I don't like melt on my ice cream.
Just a little bit of melt.
It's weird. I like ice cream that's firm.
I can appreciate, you know, to each his own, right?
Yes.
That's where we're talking about differences. Everybody's got differences. You have to embrace each other and your differences.
I like my ice cream firm and plenty.
I like mine kind of melty, not melted.
Soft and
sloppy. Sometimes you approach the microwave in an improper state of mind, and you might just hit the 1 minute button, and you mean to come back in 15 seconds, but things occur.
Things occur. Like that walk to you warp through two different time zones to the couch and back, and you came back. Whoa, fuck.
I know. It was like earlier when I fucking skipped a beat because I started thinking about the book over here. Mm-hmm. The car's still going over here. It's like, hey. And I'm like, what the fuck was I talking about?
That's
book's almost done.
Man, you are making headway on the book, that is for sure.
And it's good headway.
Yeah.
It feels real good.
Yep. Good discussion today.
We'll, yeah. Yeah.
I think you're getting close to edit time.
Yep. I'm going to be posting the sample for the book cover. It's not the finished. We're still working on it.
On your GoFundMe page? We should bring it up again.
Why not? We should. Yeah, but still, before we get to that, I'm going to be posting the mock-up of the book cover on the Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Tumblr, you know, just hit them all.
Cool.
It's like a 4 social channel tour.
Nice. Like Mayweather McGregor.
Yeah, kind of. I don't. Oh, they're shit talking. I just don't make any money doing it.
No. You don't make $100 million.
GoFundMe so far, I'm up to $300 of my $5,500 goal. So it's like I'm getting there. I'm almost to 10%. No, 1%. I'm almost to
1%. 300 more than you had to begin with.
No, it is 10%. Yeah, I'm almost to 10%. So.
You want to chip in a little bit to help him get his audiobook made? Because writing, it's one thing. It's getting talent to record it to an audiobook and get it on audible.com is a completely different thing.
Not necessarily cheap, but I thought this time I'd try and ask for a little bit of help. And I've got a GoFundMe page, and we'll put it on the comments. Or you'll see it at the bottom, like down below. That's what they say.
Yeah, and we'll put it down
below. We'll put it down below.
It'll be down here somewhere.
It's going to be down below. We're going to do cool.
And then over here somewhere, over there or down here, there's a subscribe button. If you like us, subscribe to us.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. I want to practice YouTube whoring.
This is we need tax people advisors
Yeah, those I always wanted to use one of those, but I got to use one once and I didn't understand the fuck I was doing. I just kind of looked like, well, someone.
Typewriters were fun. Yes. I like those. Those were cool.
Do you know in House of Cards, one thing they didn't have, because the Kevin Spacey's character's name is Underwood, right? I think they, and maybe they did and I missed it, because it's quite possible that that could have happened.
You were inebriated?
Not necessarily.
You did an intervention.
Yes. Bring your friends. But I always thought it'd be cool to have, because you see him on a typewriter a lot. I think it would have matched his vanity perfectly if it was an Underwood typewriter. The old school, because Underwood is like the old skeleton looking ones.
Gotcha.
Yeah, those are the Underwoods.
Are they like renowned in the typewriting society?
They were prevalent.
Prevalent.
And back in the day, I mean, they were the typewriter gods at the time.
Did they have the whole case, that the hard case would go around it with the
handle? No, that came later. No, these were like big fucking black big keys. And
you're passionate about this fucking thing.
They were cool. I had one.
Where did the keyboard touch you, John?
Show me on this keyboard.
Show me on this keyboard, yeah. So I think we are up to, we're over an hour.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, come on. We got to have more stuff to talk about.
I don't have much more to talk about. And you have to take your lovely wife out tonight.
Yes, we're going out for a special date at JCPenney's in Southdale. It's closing. Liquidation sale.
Everything must go.
Only selling the edge of the seat, because that's all you'll need. Sorry.
Monday, the Metrodome. Gravedigger.
So, are there any other movies? No. No more movies.
No movies.
I'm almost done with the book. We talked about that. Yep. You're pulling it again? Talked about that?
I played some games.
What are you playing?
I played the Destiny 2 beta.
How is that?
It's good. It's what I kind of expected. Actually, a little bit more.
Is that all online, or is that...
Yeah, for the most part, yeah.
Okay,
so you have to be hooked up online.
No, yeah. No. What I mean is, it's not campaign.
No, it's weird.
Is it like an interactive campaign?
Think about Destiny like this, because behind the scenes, this is what it does, and I won't get in great detail. It's a single-player game you play when you're doing the campaign stuff,
right?
Not doing, you know, dungeons and crap like that. Think of it like playing Halo, where in the background, it's randomly doing matchmaking for you, and in some areas that are big and open in the campaign, it will assign people to your game with you.
Okay.
So then they just kind of
like
appear.
In WoW, where you get dungeons, yep. You go fucking run
so
a dungeon.
It's crazy. And here's the other crazy part about it. It's not done server side. It's done peer-to-peer. So one system hosts it, and the other players come to it. So think about managing that.
No, well, peer-to-peer, everybody would be
meaning
playing against
your
everybody.
System turns into the server.
Oh, for that,
those people in,
for that dungeon,
three
for that
people.
Instance. Got it.
So that's...
I didn't know what you were saying, boy. You got to talk with the marbles outside your mouth.
Because normally games like, wow, everyone's talking to a main server somewhere in the United States, so we all have the same ping and whatever, depending on your location. Where in Destiny, it does a matchmaking behind the scenes.
Right.
That pairs you to people localized to the same node that you're on. So I think we go to Chicago servers mostly, right? So other people go to Chicago... who are in your same,
network area
and skill level.
Okay,
it'll pair you up with them, and it does that behind the scenes.
So, but how much? What kind of processing is actually going on your system?
Enough to make the game run at 30 FPS when it shouldn't. It's constantly hitting your CPU on your system. Yeah, which it kind of.
So you'd
want
to have a really nice GPU, right?
Well, here's the deal: Destiny 1 did not come to PC. Destiny 2 is coming to PC, and that will run at full on. You can max everything out, run at 60 plus frames per second.
As a server too, because you're just serving up data, right? You're not.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what it is, but you're basically serving up the information of where they are compared to you, what they're using gun wise, what they're doing stats wise. I mean, it's basically turning your computer into a server, and then you all talk to their main servers with just very baseline data. Which is crazy because it cuts the bandwidth down.
Right.
And they don't need a huge infrastructure to manage it.
Huh.
Pretty smart.
That's pretty smart.
Yeah.
I haven't played games in a while. Well, I've been so busy.
Busy, yeah.
Well, I just got to a point with the games. And don't get me wrong, I'm not knocking games at all. I love games. In fact, I can honestly say that I miss games.
Yeah.
But when I had that epiphany here just a couple years ago, when I realized that I had fewer days ahead than I do behind me, I don't know. I don't want to say I set aside my foolish ways, nothing like that. But I just when I moved, when we moved the rooms around, I just didn't break the Xbox back out, you know. And I think it was because I wanted to focus more on creating and doing some of the things I actually dream about doing that I never do because I'm usually playing games or sure, something like that. Sure. So I haven't played the Xbox in probably 6 months, man.
Yeah.
And I, like I said, you know, I love games. I mean, and I will play them again. I promise.
There's a good time and a place when you're in either a state of mind or too tired to really create. That's when it should fill that void for you.
I haven't been too tired to create in a long time.
What I mean, you spend time watching shows, which is kind of the same thing. You spend time watching YouTube. That's, to me, those in games are the exact same thing.
You know, there could be merit in what you say.
Because Game of Thrones, to me, it's awesome, but I could really be creating something, doing a lot better things with my time.
This is true. Now I feel like a terrible person.
Well, no, you mean it's, you were doing that end games.
You have a point.
There's the problem.
I feel like a better person.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yoo-hoo. So today's podcast.
No, I did that. I already. Okay, fuck it. Dick Nipple Corporation.
What do they make at Dick Nipple Corp?
They make butter churns. They're really good.
Like Amish butter churns?
Yeah. They're manual. They're wirelessly manual butter churns.
The Amish can't use wirelessly manual.
Yeah.
They can't use wireless.
There's no wires in them.
Oh, you're talking like physical wires.
Yeah, there's no wires. It's wireless. So.
Okay, how many of these did they sell already?
Four. Well.
Four?
I bought one. My brother bought two. And then we gave the other one away in a raffle.
Oh, like a meat raffle?
Like a meat raffle, but you get a free butter churn.
I like it.
Could you imagine these fucking millennials nowadays, man? Not all of them, just some of them, and you know who you are.
Fucking millennials.
You give them a fucking butter churn. Here's your job. I'm going to pay minimum wage, which is what? What's minimum wage?
Depends on the state. Some of it's
in Minnesota.
$12. Here, I think it's around eight.
Okay, so call it $8. Yeah. You're going to pay $8 an hour. All you got to do is this all day, just churn this fucking butter. So they just keep bringing cream, man. You get a fucking 15-minute smoke break. Get a half-hour lunch, 15-minute smoke break.
Churning butter.
Fucking back at it. Mm-hmm. So how long do you think, how much butter do you think they'd make?
Not much at all. I mean, it would basically be just... Okay, I churned a few times. My manager's not looking. That looks bad.
Oh, no. Yeah. See, we'd have a counter.
Oh, how many churns?
Yeah, so you'd have quota because we'd be doing trends and studies and shit and fucking closed door exams of that. You know, so we know how many fucking churns we should get, like a minute, like in the per hour per day. You know, I get that average stat per week. You know.
Okay.
See, when I'm elected president. It's going to be a different place. The Lord's going to help us. He's going to be there. Oh, man. Can I get an amen? Lord loves you.
Everybody, amen.
Amen.
All right. We're out.
Praise the Lord.
You people have a good one. We will see you not.
Try to stay out of trouble.
Next Wednesday.
Don't call me for bail money. I won't be there next Wednesday. He won't be there next Wednesday.
Somebody will. The cats will take over.
The cats will take over.
Everybody, stay classy. In John's case, start being classy. And
Dick
don't nipples. Die.
Dick Nipples.